If you've heard me say it once, you've heard me say it 1,000 times. Learning this approach is difficult. Primarily because we focus on a completely different part of the person's life than traditional psychotherapy. Being solution focused or using solution focused brief therapy means you're focusing on what is being created as opposed to the problem and or the past. But I want to talk about that a little bit. I want to kind of express that in a little bit more of a clear way and then give a different way to kind of view that to help you practice it pragmatically when you're working with your client. So we have this idea in solution-focused brief therapy called at your best. So if you've ever been to like a brief event in London, a brief international event, the online course that we teach together, or one of my events, we will often ask people to do an exercise saying get into groups, and one person asks the other, if you woke up tomorrow and you were at your best, what would you begin to notice? And I think a lot of times some people get caught up on the words, and they ask me like, you know, Elliot, when do you ask your clients this at your best question? And the answer is almost never. Like, it's not really the question that matters, it's the idea. So to give you an example, I'm currently dealing with something difficult, not stressful, not even bad, but just hard, that's requiring effort on my behalf. It's requiring me to be at my best. So if I were to come to one of you for therapy and sit down, you have to understand that this approach is an at your best movement as opposed to away from your worst movement. Because if you think about it, if I'm going to take on a major life challenge, I need to do so being at my very, very best. To give an example of this, like when I was younger, I was an athlete. I played baseball and football in college. And I wanted to keep my body at its best. So I would exercise and I would eat right and I would get proper rest. So by the time the game arrived, I was at my optimum level of performance. Well, in psychotherapy, we treat it the exact same. We treat our clients the exact same. Because clients come to therapy when they've got a challenge that they need to face, that they don't feel prepared to face, they don't feel adequate to face. And sometimes we actually make the problem worse by focusing on the problem, and then it grows, and then people feel even more intimidated or impacted by the problem. But if I can build that client up, or if the client can be built up by the conversation and remember they're at their bestness, then they're much more likely to be able to take on those challenges and accomplish big things. Like if I were to call one of you and tell you about the challenges that I'm facing, if you were to respond by saying, gosh, that sounds horrible, or, gosh, that sounds like a big deal, or oh my gosh, how are you gonna do that? I'm gonna come away from that conversation feeling much, much worse. But if you help me have a conversation, when was the last time you accomplished something like this? How did you overcome it? What do you have within inside of you that makes you capable of overcome this? If you woke up tomorrow and you were in the process of overcoming it in a way that was right for you, those things remind me of my capacities and my abilities and my strengths and my resources and help me overcome the challenges with which that I'm facing. And that's really the essence of a solution-focused brief conversation that brings about our clients at their bestness as opposed to the away from their worstness, which I think is historically what we do in psychotherapy. So I hope that that makes sense. I hope that that kind of strikes home a bit, and I hope that that gives you like a little bit of clarity and understanding on how we view our clients and the way that we function in the conversation. Is to let's build up the client resources through our conversation and our questions so that the problem shrinks. Let's not build up the problem so that the client shrinks. And all of us face challenges in life, and when we do, it's so much more helpful to think about your own resources and your own levels of brilliance and your own at your bestness. You don't have to say at your best in the session. I just want you to be thinking that my questions and the conversation should be evoking an at your bestness within the client so that they become more capable of overcoming the challenges, because that's what solution-focused brief therapy is all about. Like when you get in touch with these things, you're just much more likely to overcome challenges that have gotten in your way. We view this in all walks of life, and I want you to view this in psychotherapy and understand that that's where this idea of at your best comes from, and that's where this idea kind of hits home in solution-focused brief therapy. So I hope that that makes sense. I hope that gives you something to chew on, something to work on, something to practice with your clients. And if you like this video, please give me a share, give me a like, and absolutely comment below. I love interacting with you guys as you comment about my videos and as things make sense to you and kind of click and kind of sending me messages on what made sense and what didn't, or even asking me to make videos of things in the future. So I hope you go off and have a week where you are at your very best too.